Love to know your thoughts on the budget in general and specifically to manufacturing sector.
Yeah, so listen, overall my view on the budget is not so good actually, because I can only say that they have just been introducing new tax regimes and more complicating more, you know, the existing ones, and one side of it they are removing the taxes from one hand, but they are eventually getting it taxed on somewhere, you know, at some other end. So overall, my view for the budget is not really, I am not so satisfied, and specifically with respect to the personal income tax, the new tax regime which they have introduced. So I am typically, I am of the view that what a person is actually gaining. In the budget speech, the finance minister had said that, you know, every by resorting to the new tax scheme, the individual would be, you know, having a saving of rupees 78,000 of tax. But eventually, when we actually do a practical calculation, there is no gain. And there is, in fact, an individual may end up paying more tax if he is at a higher slab.
15 to 19 lakhs bracket ends up paying more.
Yeah.
Exactly. 15 to 19 lakhs bracket ends up paying more, because and at the same time, they have involved so many restrictions. You cannot claim LTA, you cannot claim HRA, you cannot really claim any deduction under chapter 6A. So I don't think this is actually in a way of, you know, making the tax regime simpler. Rather, it is more complicated. And again, coming back to the manufacturing sector, not many relevant changes, not significant changes, as they had already, decreased the tax rate to 15% for the new manufacturing domestic companies. At the same time, they have included one section called Section 80M, which is the deduction in respect of intercorporate dividends. So, in the Section 115BAA, which is the concessional tax scheme for the domestic companies at the rate of 22%, and 115BAB, which is 15% for the manufacturing entity. Earlier, they used to say that they cannot claim any deduction under Chapter 6A except for Section 80JJAA, that employment wala section. But now they are saying that they can claim the deduction under Section 80M, which is the dividend on the intercorporate loan, intercorporate dividend, sorry. So now they can claim that deduction, but again it is attached to the condition that the dividend has to be distributed before at least 1 month from the due date of filing of return. So which is the amendment in consequent amendment in Section 80M.
Right.
So this is, one thing is there, and then again you come back to the TPS section, which is Section 194C.
Mm-hmm.
It talks about, the contract manufacturing. So earlier what used to happen that the definition of work, which says that just a second, I will just have to refer it. Yeah, so earlier the work definition used to exclude the supplying of the product by using the raw material purchased from a third party. So what people, now they have included the term associate, which shall have the same meaning as Section 48(2), which is the related party. So now what the government is trying to do is to capture those cases where the raw material is not supplied from the customer, but it is taken from the associates of that customer. So that also will come under the contract manufacturing thing, and the TPS of 2% or 1% under Section 194C shall apply.
Right. I also read that they're trying to reduce the TDS rate for professionals or no services.
Yes.
For 94G.
So not for the services, for technical services, and professional remains the same at the rate of 10%. But under Section 194J, because of the ambiguity revolving around what will be 194C and what will be 194J, so they have reduced the tax rate to 2%. This is the change which they have done. And of course, then for the manufacturing concerns, they have included power generation units in the definition of manufacturing, so that power generation units can also avail the benefit of that 15% rate.
I think this was something which people were trying to do earlier by covering generation of power in the manufacturing definition, even when this new law came in. So I think it's more clarificatory in nature.
This is a more clarificatory.
And I don't know if there are new power plants being set up now.
In fact, there's a very big jolt to the sector. The biggest push this government is giving on the renewable side.
Right.
They have imposed a 20% basic custom duty on import of solar modules from China.
Yeah.
So there is a huge disconnect now in terms of the kind of tariff that you are expecting, the kind of project implementation cost that you are looking at, 2-2.5 rupees, which you can only meet if you are importing it from China, because India doesn't have that kind of
manufacturing. But I think that I have a view on that, which is that I feel it's for betterment, because using Chinese product, a lot of these guys were able to bid at very aggressive pricing, but eventually the implementation of such projects was a big challenge, and eventual delivery of electricity from these projects have not been, the experience has not been very good. So maybe, just maybe, this pushes people to do the right pricing using the right product. Because eventually...
These all projects were done on viability gap funding reverse bidding model. So the prices, the lower band of the prices are set by the government. Now you can only choose to go lower than that. You can't go higher than that. So the price target was given by the government. You have to do a project in 2.5 rupees, 3 rupees or lower than that. Now if you are targeting
the bid will get won or lost basis the VGF you asked for. So eventually government will fund that. If someone does the project at the right price.
So now the biggest challenge is that almost 60-70% of that VGF has not been flowing, because there is again a cash shortfall with the government. So the subsidies that were announced have not come back. DISCOMs are not able to pay, so this LC-backed structure had come in, which is again yet to come into force. On top of it, now this 20% custom duty has been imposed. So the projects which you are typically still trying to compete with these Chinese vendors, you will not be able to do. So this,
I mean, having
in
spoken,
turn
yeah.
will lead to again a stress being developed. Stress would develop in the loans given by banks.
Correct.
For these projects in the solar space.
Correct. No, I take your point, but I mean, I having spoken to a few people in the industry, I mean, they are also struggling with the fact that a lot of people using Chinese equipment are bidding for the project, leaving them in a state of no competition.
The problem is, in India, we don't have any manufacturing facility which can manufacture so many modules.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, that has to be imported from somewhere. Now, whether it's German or any other European, because Chinese one have not been very successful. That's also a true reality. Which basically means that the projects which, as you rightly said, which have been funded in the past and were using Chinese product, basically there could be a lot of stress now getting created on such projects also.